I saw her on the way in. I was like, how's it going, Taylor? She's like, it's something. I'm like, I had a feeling. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. She was stage manager for a chamber dance project once, this group that I used to do. We shot my quit. Diane Colburn. Oh, it's just a string quartet. No, Claudia was the first. Which was great, back then. A little more difficult for me to play with her, just because I have the That's beside the point. It's me, Sean, doing it. Like a mosquito bar, like gladiator style amphitheater. Like, so
Really enjoyed it.
I know, it was nuts. It was nuts. And then it was scary.
Thank you. Good evening. Please take your seats. Our show will begin shortly. Good evening. Please take your seats. The show will begin shortly. Thank you.
finds a place where we feel the most comfort and love. It is filled with memories of our youth and dreams of our future. Some dreams may fade over time, but others cling to us and become an instrumental part of who we are. They guide us throughout our life and direct us to the paths that we were destined to take. Our dream serves as a reminder that we are capable of anything in this life if we just believe. From a young age, I always knew that my life would be in fashion. I knew this wouldn't be easy, but it was something inside of me that reminded me that this was my fate. Trial and error, long nights, pursuing those many things that in the moment seemed impossible, but just doing all you can to never give up. It's the kind of feeling that you can't describe while you're in it. But when you look back, you're like, wow, that really needed to happen. I've always wanted my impact on fashion to go beyond the clothes. I want women to feel loved, to see themselves as limitless in a world that may be screaming otherwise. This moment today is surreal. Experience the Hanifa dream here in DC. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.